The Honourable Member for Fort Garry-Riverview.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. The Health Minister will know that fentanyl has had a devastating impact in Fort Garry-Riverview, as it has all across Manitoba. I know that the Health Minister met with families at the end of October, and I appreciate him taking the time to do so. But those families want to do more than just tell stories, Madam Speaker. They're looking for the government to show leadership and take real action. Can the Health Minister tell the House today when he's going to start putting real investments into harm reduction strategies and treatment options for Manitobans?
The Honourable Minister of Health, Seniors and Active Living.
Madam Speaker, one of the great challenges with the issue of fentanyl and carfentanil is that so many individuals who are dying, and not just in Manitoba, but in other provinces, and we know certainly in British Columbia, there are hundreds that are dying, Madam Speaker, is they never actually get the treatment because they're not aware of what it is that they are taking. Part of the solution, part of the challenge for us is to ensure we get as much information out. Those who are using drugs and might be putting themselves in risky situations just simply by using drugs don't understand the degree of the risk when it might be mixed with fentanyl and carfentanil. That is an education issue. That's part of what we need to do, and we've committed to doing that, and we will, Madam Speaker.
The Honourable Member for Fort Garry-Riverview on a supplementary question.
Well, Madam Speaker, public education on this question is critically important, but the government has an obligation to do more than just hang posters across Manitoba. Families are asking the government to show leadership and take real action for harm reduction strategies and for treatment options for those suffering from addiction. We need to get by the minister's procrastination on this file, and we're asking him right now, today, to tell us what's his plan for Manitobans.
The Honourable Minister of Health, Seniors and Active Living.
Well, Madam Speaker, I was hoping this wouldn't turn political because I don't think it should be a political debate. I know that earlier this year, when the former government was still in government, they took action on fentanyl by putting up posters in bus stops and around of the city. I was never critical about that because I think that that's actually not an unimportant thing to do in terms of education. I think more needs to be done with that. I've already indicated, earlier today before a question period, that we'll be expanding the use of naloxone. There are different things we could look towards when it comes to alternative treatment therapies. But one of the great concerns that I have, Madam Speaker, is that many of the people who are dying have never gone or looked for treatment because they don't know what it is that they're taking, and they don't know the outcome potentially of taking drugs that might be mixed with fentanyl. So it's not just about putting up posters, but that's not a bad thing, and his government did it as well, Madam Speaker.